Our town of Long Beach is proudly used as a filming location for many television and movies. It's been seen as Miami Beach in stories, and most recently in the movie La La Land. One of the venues used was right here on 3rd Street, the Cordova Apartments. And we're going to take a look inside. One of the longer scenes in the movie that was cut short was Mia and her three roommates walking through this courtyard in brightly colored dresses, all dancing as they were ready for an evening on the town.
They rehearsed it all day. So they'd play one, two, three, four, and then the music would start, the girls would come down, and the Steadicam guy started with the girls coming down the stairs all the way in the back on the patio, and he's backing up, and the music starts, they come down, all the way down the stairs, come down through the patio, and he's going all the way back. They had like a cherry picker. He backed into, he's still shooting, backed into the cherry picker, and the cherry picker lifted him up. That was all one take.
Just up the stairs from here, apartment number 16, was where Mia and her three roommates lived. In reality, it's a two-bedroom apartment, so it must have been cozy. Mia and her roommates danced their way through the courtyard, across the way, and onto 3rd Street for the iconic, classical look of a 1930s musical as they danced their way along 3rd Street. We're on Bird Lane right now, the alley behind the Cordova apartment, where Mia is picked up for a date by Sebastian in his red convertible. Long Beachers all know it's our town when they see the purple recycling bins in the background, and as Gosling heads along Bird towards Gaviota, the wrong way in his red convertible. But we're gonna go the right way to our next location. When Hollywood location movie scouts were looking for the hippest bar, they found Long Beach and the Blind Donkey.
They built out the stage. I mean, they brought a grand piano down here, which is no easy feat. The stairwell is very narrow. The crew, they worked like a colony of ants to get that thing down those stairs. It was quite marvelous. And they built out the stage maybe 15 feet to fit it on there. And that was a feat just to watch those guys set up and even break down. But just bringing that grand piano down was something to see. If the Gazette readers are interested in coming, I think Sunday, Mondays are great because it's sort of laid back and there's sort of more ambiance, and you can enjoy whiskey and enjoy sort of the place and the liveliness of the place without it being too amped up.
Behind me is where Mia first saw the sign of the logo she designed for Sebs. Ryan Gosling actually learned how to play piano for this role, and this was the stage he played on. And it was right about here that Mia's eyes met Sebastian's. Thanks, Kyle, and everybody at the Blind Donkey. I'm Joe Murray, and until our next Joe Venture, we'll see you again.